Scientists create the whitest white paint ever that can cool buildings down more than an air conditioner. Harvard professor sells his genome sequence as an NFT. Wow. And MIT researchers develop AI to calculate the material stress using images. What is happening, YouTube? Cyberstruck here, and today we have some amazing tech news to cover for you. So, without further ado, Musica Maestro. So, last week, mechanical engineer at Purdue University in Indiana, Shulin Ruan, produced the whitest white paint ever after trying more than 100 materials, 50 formulations, and 6 years of research. The aim, said Ruan, is to keep the temperature inside the building's core, similar to an air conditioner, but without the need of electricity. Commercial white paints reflect between 80 to 90% of sunlight, which is not sufficient to help buildings stay cool during the day. The new paint, however, reflects up to 98.1% of sunlight and is based on barium sulfate, a compound used to whiten photo paper and cosmetics. According to the study, barium sulfate is also environmentally safe and half the cost of that of titanium dioxide powder, commonly used in white paints. The scientists apply a high concentration of barium sulfate particles of different sizes. Since the wavelength reflected depends on the size of the particle, so a wide range of particle sizes helps the paint scatter more sunlight. On the other side of the spectrum, the blackest black ever produced is the Vanta Black, which absorbs up to 99.9% of visible light and was made using carbon nanotubes. Tests so far suggest that this white paint is capable of maintaining indoor temperature 19 degrees Fahrenheit or 7.2 degrees Celsius cooler than its surrounding surfaces at night and 8 degrees Fahrenheit or 13.3 degrees Celsius cooler during intense noon sunlight. The reason why this matters is because regions like Hong Kong have a severe AC problem in terms of energy consumption and social perception. If you want to know what I mean by this, check out this fantastic video by Kento Bento on Asia's air conditioning dependency. So forget about sunscreen. Do white paint. Now, a couple of weeks ago, here in Cyberstruck, we covered the largest NFT sale in history of a digital artwork by artist Beeple for a mind-blowing $69 million. But in case you missed it, head over here to find out what an NFT is. And having said that, scientist George Church is auctioning off his genome as an NFT. Professor George Church teaches genetics at Harvard Medical School and MIT, leads synthetic biology at the Wyss Institute, overseeing the evolution of molecules, polymers, and genomes to create new tools with applications in regenerative medicine, and is also director of the U.S. Department of Energy Technology Center and director of the National Institutes of Health Center of Excellence in Genomic Science. Among his achievements in the genomics field, it is worth mentioning his contribution to gene therapy, synthetic DNA, and full human genome sequencing. He also founded DigiDate, a dating service that matches users based on their genetic information to minimize the odds of passing genetic disorders onto the offspring, and Nebula Genomics, a company that provides genome sequencing on demand. And now, the professor is auctioning the artistic representation of his genome sequencing in the form of an NFT, which will encode the digital location in a decentralized server through blockchain technology. The idea behind this is that each human's genome is a non-changing representation of their most fundamental and personal data, which is, in itself, non-fungible. Nebula co-founder Kamal Obad said that patients with a rare disease may be able to exchange their genome sequence with pharma companies for a higher value than healthy patients, because it could potentially unveil what is causing that disease and how a treatment will look like. And before we move on to the next news, do you remember this old meme of a little girl in front of a burning house? Well, she just sold the meme, the original picture, as an NFT for $500,000. How about that? And last but not least, we have a new AI tool that can calculate the material stress and strain based on pictures. For centuries, engineers have relied on the laws of physics to understand the stress and strain on the materials they work with. But solving those equations can be computationally challenging, especially for complex materials. MIT researchers have developed a technique to quickly determine certain properties of a material, like stress and strain, based on an image of the material showing its internal structure. The approach could eliminate the need for complex physics-based calculations and instead rely on computer vision and machine learning to generate estimates in real time. Performing these calculations correctly is crucial, since it will determine, for instance, how a bridge can hold up amid heavy traffic loads or high winds. But the process is expensive and can take up to months to run the required simulations. To solve this, the MIT researchers have developed an artificial intelligence algorithm based on generative adversarial neural networks, or GAN, training it with thousands of paired images. One showing the material's internal microstructure subject to mechanical forces, and the other depicting the same material's color-coded stress and strain values. With these pairs, the network uses principles of game theory to figure out the relationships between the geometry of a material and its resulting stress, so it can predict the deformations and stress a material may go through. Forces on a material can operate differently at atomic and macro scale, and this is where the GAN excels, since it convolutes the information at progressively larger scales, making it a great fit for describing material properties. So far, the AI has successfully rendered the stress and strain lines on close-up images of several composite materials and even captured developing cracks, which is crucial information for the material scientists. This breakthrough may have a very significant impact in the automotive and aircraft industries and engineer biomaterials. In other words, it is a big deal. And that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed this episode, and we'll see you very soon in the next one. Take care.